he wrote about the bedroom painting both to his brother and to Gauguin, and he specifically says how the walls were supposed to be lilac, and the doors violet, and the floor was this deeper kind of a red tile. And so there's clear evidence that the painting was supposed to be, you know, purplish, which is now blue. There were certain paints that the Impressionists were using and the Post-Impressionists, and paints that he was really fond of, known as lake pigments, where some of them had these brilliant colors, purples and magentas, and even in some cases yellows, and they would fade with light exposure. And he was aware of some of these color changes, and so what he wrote about was, I'm now laying on the paint really thickly so that hopefully it will slow down the process, or we'll be able to appreciate the painting for a longer period of time. And perhaps some of his impasto techniques, his paint buildup, is because of that. The field of conservation science is largely applied analytical chemistry, and this painting was analyzed in order to identify the specific lake pigments that he used that were faded, so that once we know what those pigments are, then we can prepare samples using the same materials, and that provides us the ground truth. I also plan to use this in educational material. I'm working on a new iBook, which will be Color Science for Artists. And I'll have a chapter in there that talks about, you know, paintings and drawings changing because of poor materials, and these will be incredible examples. And so I imagine he would have been pretty dismayed to see that change, and then to see our ability to bring it back, though it's speculative, but nonetheless, I think he would have been really excited about that, to see it come back.